Review code provided by PlayStation. Reviewed on PS5 and PS4 Pro. Ever since 2018's Marvel Spider-Man for PlayStation 4 concluded its storyline with the Silver Lining DLC, Insomniac Games have been teasing us with a Miles Morales-centric game until a few months ago. The announcement of a Miles Morales game has surprised most of us, even when Insomniac Games hid the secret in the plain sight. 2018's Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse has dramatically popularized Miles Morales in the pop culture. However, this version of Miles is completely different from the movie. This is Insomniac's own version of the character, separate from the comics or movies. Right off the bat with the intro, Miles feels familiar, yet different. He's been Spider-Man for about 1 year and has been training with his mentor, Peter Parker, who also is a great friend. The story picks off 1 year after the events of the original game and starts off with a sweet spider training sequence that quickly transitions into an action-packed visual spectacle and ends up leaving Miles as New York's only Spider-Man while Peter goes on a working vacation to Simcaria with MJ. The core of the story revolves around Miles exploring his new powers, getting to know his neighborhood, and standing up for his new home, Harlem. The entire story presents an evolution of Miles from being a Spider-Man into becoming the Spider-Man while taking its time for humorous, deeply emotional, and low moments of the characters involved. The main villain has connections to Miles on a super emotional level, and overall the villain roster is not so huge but very compelling with their respective narratives. The music is composed by the spectacular John Paisano. It is not just your traditional orchestra but a fusion of orchestra and hip-hop. The creative director Brian Horden suggested that they call it the orchestral synth-hop. Pretty cool name. Along with the composed music, there are a few licensed songs as well, all of which set the tone and mood of the game perfectly. The music while swinging is also amazing. Voice actor Naji Jader captures the youthful excitement and enthusiasm of a high school teenager damn near perfectly. From exhilarated screams during swinging to heartfelt emotional moments, Naji Jader nails the role through his voice and facial capture brilliantly. Along with Miles, all of the characters in the game demonstrate outstanding performances. Not only is the voice acting and motion capture top-notch, but also the characters themselves feel a lot more natural and practical throughout the game in comparison to the original. Miles moves very differently to Peter in this game. Insomniac has gone above and beyond to truly make Miles unique to his character while keeping the base mechanics of the game intact. Starting from the walking and running animations, web zipping, point launching, web strike takedowns, and basically every little way Miles moves feels unique to himself. Watching Miles glide across the city as he swings is nothing short of an eye candy. The traversal system has been improved several times over the original with the deeper Atrix system that keeps you engaged literally every second while you're in the air. The new Atrix system also lets you experience the Spider-Man moves that you probably never have witnessed Spider-Man do before in any form of media. Miles shows off his style, fluidity, excitement, and inexperience when swinging or during combat. Speaking of combat, Miles has got explosive new powers that differentiates him from Peter. Whether you are electrifying enemies with Venom combat or taking them down quietly with the camouflage ability, the combat feels extremely fun and opens up quite a huge number of possibilities. On top of the camouflage ability, ceiling and wall takedowns add more to the stealth than the previously established stealth mechanics in the original. Suit mods this time around are much more useful depending on the situation you are in. The new finishes are brilliantly thought out and well implemented with excellent camera work. Some of the suits have their own finishes, which not only adds to your style but also lets you explore the variety that they bring to the table. There are new crime types as well, which play very similar to the original. However, you can always choose to replay every single crime type from the FNSM app in the game. The side missions this time around are more meaningful with some deeply emotional moments and tap into the theme of becoming the friendly neighborhood Spider-Man. And yeah, Howard is back with his pigeons. Gotta love that. A good chunk of the game involves well-designed environmental puzzles that do not feel repetitive. The replayability factor for this one is much higher, as Insomniac attempts to reward players when they choose to play through the game yet another time. The PS5 version of this game is the definitive experience, with enhanced graphics and performance modes, with added DualSense and 3D audio support. But the PS4 version is beautiful and well executed in its own right. For example, this section where the open world loads instantly is also possible on PS4. The final verdict. Marvel's Spider-Man Miles Morales is a shorter, more jam-packed title that perfectly kicks off a new generation of gaming. The story is more focused and filled with great details and high stakes that almost makes it an essential sequel to experience in the Insomniac Spider-Man universe. It reminds us that anyone can indeed wear the mask, and you will be greater if you can be yourself.